amputee shot and killed by a Houston police officer this morning. That officer shot and killed a one-armed, one-legged man in a wheelchair when he apparently refused to drop an item which turned out to be a pen. Hello again, everyone. Welcome to Eyewitness News at 6. I'm Tom Abrams.
I'm Adelia Uchida. The officer claims the man in the wheelchair had him cornered and made repeated threats.
It wasn't until after the officer killed him that he realized the man was just holding that pen. It happened just southeast of downtown Houston at the Healing Hands Group Home for the Mentally Ill. Eyewitness News reporter Crystal Cobza was there and spoke to the owner of that group home.
He had one arm and one leg. He was in a wheelchair.
Mentally ill and handicapped is how the owner of this group home described the man shot and killed by a Houston police officer this morning. According to John Garcia, owner of the Healing Hands Group Home, the caretaker staying overnight called 911 after the man became more and more aggressive.
He wanted some sodas at like 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock in the morning. And he kept, insisting to give him to him or some cigarettes, and got really aggressive, so he just called 911.
According to a police spokesperson, the man kept swinging an object at the two officers when they arrived and entered the home. After numerous requests to drop the object, police said the man cornered one of the officers in the room. It was then the officer's partner opened fire.
The other officer, Officer Marin, in fear of the safety of his partner and in the safety of himself, discharged his duty weapon, striking the suspect.
Now, according to the owner of the home, the caretaker who was inside of this home at the time of the shooting was asked by police officers to step out of the home. It was at that point when he was standing out here on the sidewalk that he heard a single gunshot inside of the home. According to police, the object the man was swinging turned out to be a ballpoint pen.
At the table, he'd write on a pad of paper, and he was always doodling. So
for those officers in there, they maybe didn't know what he was holding.
Correct.
Garcia tells us although the man was confined to a wheelchair, he was capable of making a person feel threatened during a time of outrage, adding it's an everyday challenge taking care of the mentally ill.
You just never know when they go off. That's all you can say. You just don't know.
Crystal Cobza, 13 Eyewitness News.
Now, according to the group home owner, the man who was shot and killed suffered from bipolar disorder and schizophrenia. He had lost an arm and a leg after being run over by a train years ago. The owner of the group home says two other residents were there at the time of the shooting, along with the caretaker. All of them were questioned by police.
I'm a Jew, he a Jew, she a Jew, we some Jews, wouldn't you like to be a Jew too? Only if you're in the bloodline.
A wheelchair-bound man is dead after an officer opens fire. That officer says the man was waving something in a threatening manner. It turns out that man was holding a pen.
Andrew Horansky is in southeast Houston with more on what happened early this morning. Andrew.
Vicente, it all started early this morning at that house across the street. It is a group home for men with medical disabilities. They come here when they're released from hospitals and they're under 24-hour supervision. This afternoon, I spoke with the home's manager. He told me three residents were living here and that one of them had a bad episode this morning. He identified the man as Brian Clunch, a man in his mid-40s with schizophrenia and bipolar disorder. He had been living here for more than a year. He said around 2:30 this morning, Clunch began demanding cigarettes and soda and became irate when a worker told him he'd have to wait for that. Eventually, that person called 911 and police arrived. Two officers went in. They say the suspect soon cornered one of them and ignored their orders, so the officer shot and killed him. However, there are some serious questions since it turns out Clunch was a wheelchair-bound double amputee. He had one leg and one arm and a pen in his hand.
Did he ever feel threatening to you because those officers felt threatened this morning?
He had a temper. He could fly off once in a while. So I don't know. I'm not trying to justify or say he did anything or they did anything.
Garcia said that Clunch could be a likable guy when he wanted to be. It's still unclear whether the lights were on or off this morning. According to HPD, the quarters in there are very cramped, which was a factor in that officer's decision this morning. Reporting live in southeast Houston, I'm Andrew Horansky, KHOU 11 News.
Neighborhood. My last story. Houston PD kills wheelchair-ridden, schizophrenic, double amputee armed with a pen. Now, that sounds like some type of skit from Chappelle's show, so let me read that to you one more time. Houston PD kills wheelchair-ridden, schizophrenic, double amputee, armed with a pen. Keep this in mind as we go through the article. A spokesman for Houston PD says the officer couldn't make out what the metal object in the man that the man waved was. It was later determined that the object was a pen. After the mentally ill man refused to comply with police orders to put the pen down, police opened fire without thinking twice to reach for a taser instead of a gun. The author makes a very good point, but I think even a taser in this situation would be more than excessive. The man had one arm, he had one leg. And let's say, in my understanding about a knife or a edged weapon, bladed weapon, I don't know what you can mistake a pen to be, possibly some type of ice pick. My understanding is these things are considered dangerous within 21 feet. I'm not sure how close the officers were, but let's say the guy was coming at them with the instrument being a pen. Now, I don't know if he's got one of the old wheelchairs that he has to roll with one hand, or even if he has one of the newer ones with the joystick. Even if he was going to use the joystick, he has to hold the pen and the joystick in the same hand because he only has one hand to use. So how much of a threat is this guy driving around? I'm not making a joke. The guy had to drive around like this with the pen in one hand as well as the joystick. How much of a threat is this guy to these big, tough Houston PD officers? It's ridiculous. It's just another sad case of police brutality, and we would like to show you, more, things of cops changing tires and helping old ladies walk across the street. But hey, this is, these are the stories that we unfortunately get to tell, because we even had a chance, me and Darren McBreen, we did a man on the street. We encountered some very nice, friendly, professional police officers, but they didn't want to talk on camera, so we didn't have a chance to interview them. But hey, guys like this, shooting and killing wheelchair-ridden, schizophrenic, double amputee gentlemen armed with pens. I guess that's your new police force.
Please don't tase me. Don't tase me, bro. I'm an old man. I got a heart condition.
Yo, what up with it, man? It's your boy, O to the D. I was just catching up on my wrestling, you know what I'm saying? They just had Monday Night Raw, for all y'all that don't know. But let me pause there, man. It's your boy, O to the D, a.k.a. Niners General of the Jews, doing my thing, man. Another video. I'm bringing you another video, and y'all see the video of it. You know, news people talking about it, so you know it's real. But I'm bringing you another video of yet the police murdering people. You know, and that's what it's called, is murdering. You got tasers, you got billy clubs, you got all this other stuff to beat us up with, you got guns to kill us with. You know, and they just killing people for no reason. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's to a point where you don't even want to go outside, because you never know, you could get caught up in a traffic stop. They could not like you and think you somebody else and just smoke you for no reason. They just shot this dude in Houston. One arm, one leg, and he allegedly had a pen. Well, he had a pen in his hand, and he allegedly had the cops backed in the corner, and he was scaring them with the pen, and it was two officers, I may add, two officers. This dude got one arm and one leg, and like they said on Alex Jones, man, if you got one arm, then how's you steering the wheelchair? You know, if it's electric, you still got to use a hand regardless. So that means he was rolling the wheelchair with his hands, and he's stuck in one spot with a knife-looking object, I guess is what they call it. So that's turns for you to shoot him in his tool, y'all. You could have ran around the wheelchair. Y'all could have both ran different directions. You could have tased him. Don't tase me, bro. You tase people all the time. You could have tased him, or y'all could have ran different sides on him, and he can't cut both of y'all. One of y'all have been able to get behind him and wrap his hands up. Like, I don't get it. Well, wrap. But matter of fact, you can run on the side where he ain't got a hand. You got an arm. I don't get it. Like, it was no pretenses, no reason for you to smoke this dude. Then you're inside of a mentally ill place, too, so you know he's mentally gone. So, you know, I didn't work the nursing home. So how do you just, take somebody like that who's flipping out? You don't try to subdue him or nothing. You just smoke him? How's this happening in America? You know, y'all better wake up, man. This is happening everywhere. This is happening right in front of us. And if you don't stand up now, you won't have a chance to stand up later. You know, even though some people say, what does me standing up do? You know, I'm not going to change nothing. Don't look at it like that, because the Lord looking at what you're doing. So when you stand up, the Lord is like, okay, I'm riding with you. Even if don't nobody else see it, the Lord saw that you wanted to stand up. was tired of it, you woke up. See, it's not what the crowd is doing. Please don't pay attention to what the crowd is doing. Because what the crowd is doing is obsolete to what you should be doing. What the crowd is doing, you should be doing the opposite. That's why I'm considered weird. And people look at me strange because some of the people that I know and kick it around, they don't do none of the stuff I do. Like, they're not really into the truth movement like I am, you know? And people say I should break away from them, which, I mean, I feel like I lightweight half. I don't kick it around everybody every day. I'm not out clubbing. I'm not out doing this and doing that. So I feel like I did break away, but I still keep in contact with my people. They're still my family, you know? But I don't do what the crowd is doing. If I was doing what the crowd was doing, I'd be wearing tight pants, dug in, sleep, not even worrying about what's going on in life, just focusing on getting money, doing it to females, you know, being gangster, making it as a rapper, I guess is what you want to say. So I'm not nothing like the crowd, so please don't be like the crowd. I'm just putting that out there. But man, it's getting serious out here, man. Getting serious out here. So are you men enough to stand up to this tyranny? It's not right for cops to just kill people. It's been happening. I've been covered a couple of times. Like when they shot the dude 30 times. You know what I mean? Come on, man. Y'all ain't getting it yet. They killed the homeless man. Y'all ain't getting it yet. It's like the movies. But anyway, but it's real life. Anyway, it's your boy, all to the D, man. I'm signing out, you know. Dee-talk, elite. It's your boy, Knowledge. So, I'm just going to say what I always say about this time. I do this. Crazy Crew Entertainment, man. Crew Die Videos, and ain't nothing after that. You dig, you beezies.